Well, good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining us. City Council meets today and we have a lot on the agenda. But I wanted to start off this morning by addressing the 2022 federal budget. As my statement said last night, this budget fails to address the City of Toronto's request for operating budget support. The city requires immediate support from the Government of Canada of $235 million for outstanding 2022 COVID-19 shortfalls to match the Government of Ontario's confirmed commitment. This shortfall is almost entirely due to decreased TTC ridership last year and our increased homelessness costs during the pandemic. As you know, the 2023 city budget finalized last month also includes a $933 million shortfall due to ongoing COVID-19 costs, again, largely transit and shelter costs. I'm disappointed the Deputy Prime Minister, a Toronto MP, would ignore a direct commitment the federal Liberals made during the last election to the City of Toronto. I'm thankful for the many productive conversations I've had with many Toronto area MPs who understand the importance of making investments in transit and housing for our most vulnerable. As a city, we made the decision to fund transit and fund unprecedented homelessness supports throughout the pandemic so that we protected the TTC and we protected our most vulnerable residents. It was the right thing to do. We have raised property taxes every year, including this year, with the largest property tax increase since amalgamation. And we have introduced new revenue tools available to us, including the city building levy and the vacant home tax to help fund our budgets. The city has also found $2.5 billion in offsets, savings, and efficiencies during the pandemic, including $786 million this year. We have been very clear to the Government of Canada what the city's needs are and about the importance of supporting Toronto, the country's economic engine. My job right now is to stand up for Toronto, and I won't hesitate to fight to make sure our city and its residents receive our fair share from other governments. Our advocacy will continue in the weeks and months ahead. Last December, City Council voted to request the Government of Canada honor its federal election campaign commitment and help address the 2022 budget shortfall. In the event that the Government of Canada failed to honor its election commitment, Council directed the Chief Financial Officer and Treasurer to include the impact of the lack of funding in the 2023 property tax notices. While I hope that we can still find a way for our two governments to work together in this interim period to address Toronto's immediate budget issues, this message will be delivered in every 2023 final property tax notice. Our ongoing financial challenges demonstrate that we need a new fiscal framework for Toronto. I remain committed to having those discussions with the provincial and federal governments. At this council meeting, the first item of business is a report from city staff on the long-term financial update and outlook. I think this report provides an important look at the city's long-term financial pressure and the picture beyond our immediate issues. It shows the progress we have made addressing the capital backlog with initiatives like the City Building Fund, but it also shows that raising property taxes or slashing services won't solve this long-term issue. The report clearly shows that Toronto needs a new fiscal framework. As noted in the report, the city faces operating and capital pressures of $46.5 billion over the next 10 years, with the major drivers being our state of good repair and transit costs. This is a revenue structural issue, which is the result of a mismatch between the responsibilities placed on Toronto by other orders of government and our lack of legal and revenue-raising powers that are available to the province and the federal government. The report is also clear that the city cannot use its reserves or deferred revenues as a balancing strategy to offset its short or long-term financial pressures. The next steps in the report are clear. The city is conducting a full assessment of all revenue tools within its jurisdiction. And as I said, We know this issue cannot be resolved through increased property taxes or reducing service levels alone. The magnitude is simply too large. The second key item at council today is a report from city staff on Smart Track. The city government, with the cooperation of our federal and provincial partners, is finally moving forward with getting transit built. We are at a key moment where we can make sure we keep moving transit forward that will benefit generations to come. As the city staff report notes, the Smart Track Stations program represents a significant investment to improve transportation choices within Toronto and leverages existing transit infrastructure to serve more people. Combined with Metrolinx's GO expansion program, Smart Track will accelerate the transformation of heavy rail infrastructure in Toronto from a regional commuter service into an urban rapid transit network, bringing transit faster to communities across the city. Shovels could be in the ground this year for some stations, and some stations could be open to riders in 3 years. The staff report is clear that this project, like everything else right now, is grappling with increased costs. I believe in spending money to get transit built, not spending millions and then letting transit projects fall by the wayside due to politics. I'm so proud of our city's progress on transit. I look forward to seeing this project move forward and seeing transit built in the city of Toronto. I'm now happy to take your questions on these items or any other matters. So you're going to see those cuts rapidly happen in 2024 if we don't get assistance. We are able to use the reserves we've squirreled away to pay for this year. But it's not a good strategy going forward. It's like taking out your RRSPs to pay your mortgage or to pay your groceries. It's not sustainable. We need a new fiscal framework. We need the province and the federal government to start having those conversations with us right now. So the provincial government came through with the 2022 operating funds that we asked for. The province did step up around that, and they have committed to an ongoing conversation about 2023. The federal government has not stepped up with the 2022 operating costs. That's urgent. Property tax notices are being prepared at the end of this week. They did not give us a commitment to 2022, and they have not committed to ongoing conversations about 2023 either. Within the provincial budget, there was also good news for Toronto in there. There was $48 million for supportive housing. There was $500 million across the province. We're looking to see what the city's share is in mental health. There was funding for guns and gangs. There was funding for fair integration of our system throughout the GTA. And there was funding for the Runnymede Mental Health Center. These are tangible investments in Toronto. We're not seeing that in the federal government, and they're not stepping up with the conversation with us about how we move forward together. It's going in the tax notices, and that's going to be a big awakening for Toronto residents to see that in their tax bill when it arrives. We're continuing that advocacy. Many of the Toronto MPs are engaging in those conversations with us. I'm hopeful that they can continue to put pressure on their leaders of their government to step up for Toronto. I'm a collaborator by nature. This is what I do. This is why I was a scientist. And even as a politician, I have that same approach of collaboration. And I'm really, really hopeful that we can get this conversation going with the federal government so that we can help the people of Toronto. I'm saying Toronto deserves better. We need to have an important conversation about how to help the country's largest economic engine. We need to work together so that we can solve these really crucial problems around homelessness and around operating of the TTC. Toronto needs to be successful so our country is successful. So that will be decided through the 2024 budget process. And that is the important conversations that we're going to have to Toronto residents. What are the services that you want to see protected? But we also need to have a very real conversation about what things the City of Toronto provides that is better provided or funded by other levels of government. So the other levels of government either need to come through with additional revenue tools so that we can fund these things, or they need to help us with those costs directly for those items. We are operating social supports out of a property tax base. This is at a scale that other municipalities simply aren't. We're also operating the largest transit system in our country. And it is being used by people across the whole region, not just Toronto residents. So I think there's a strong case to be made for operating support for the TTC by the provincial and the federal governments. I think there's also a whole lot of social services very, very needed that they can also step up with. So that is something that we'll be asking city staff this morning as we discuss the financial outlook. We have been very careful to start to earmark reserves so that they can cover this year's costs. I do think we had high hopes for the 2022 federal money. So we do need to confirm that with this funding not coming through for the federal government, the 2023 plan can still go forward. Well, what this budget reads as when I look at it is a budget that is very focused on growth. And I understand that. We want our country to grow. The problem is Toronto is still very much in the mode of recovery, and we need help with recovery. We still have costs from homelessness. We still have costs from decreased ridership on the TTC. And so while the federal government wants to focus on growth, they can't leave municipalities that are very much in a state of recovery behind. The other thing they need to recognize is that while their revenue tools grow with the economy, and income tax revenue grows with the economy, the tools we have to raise revenue in the City of Toronto, namely property tax, does not grow with the economy to the same extent. We have a structural issue in the way we fund cities. We need to have that conversation. We need to solve that problem. And the conversation needs to start about it today, or there are going to be very, very big impacts for 2024. We have the ability to build transit now to keep people going where they need to go. Shovels could be in the ground for SmartTrack this year. It's important that we continue with all of those important capital projects that we have on the book. What we're having problems right now is with operating costs. We've asked for that help with that operating. If we're not getting it, then we need to have a very, very real conversation about how we fund operating in the City of Toronto. That means new revenue tools, and that means a new fiscal framework. Well, usually what happens when we start to have budget pressures is we start to scale back on state of good repair. And we know that's important. We have roads to repair. We have community centers that need repair. We have arenas I hear about all the time that need repair. So that tends to be, unfortunately, what goes first. Then we start to have looking at expansions of programs, right? And I think we'll have to, right now, another one we need to look at very closely is the TTC. We are running more service right now than we have ridership. We have about 70% ridership right now. That is the least place that I would ever like to see a cut. but we are being almost entirely funded through the fare box. That is a problem if we don't get operating TTC money from other levels of government. So other cities around the GTA, I've spoken with some of the mayors, they're not in the same situation that we are because they are not operating shelters at the scale that we are, and they are not operating a transit system at the scale that we are that has a huge decrease in ridership. Toronto is unique in many respects in just the size, the scale of our city, but there are also other municipalities around us that that have shortfalls as well, and I know that they'll be engaging in those conversations as well. It's not one size fits all. I think each municipality has a unique financial situation. I think for the most part, though, the larger cities are the ones that tend to be struggling right now. Well, I think through the past, when there's been a failure of other levels of government to step up, the City of Toronto has. And we've filled the gaps for a very long time. And we've put that on to the property tax base, and that's how we funded it. The more we just keep stepping in to solve the problems, the more we've let the provincial and the federal governments off the hook. And I think they've come to expect that we'll just figure it out. We're now at a point where, with the decreased ridership, with the level of shelter system that we're operating, we need help from those other levels of government, and it's time for them to step up. We can't continue to rely on fare revenue to fund the TTC. We need to have a long-term commitment from the other levels of government to operate transit. That happens in most major North American cities. Most other major North American cities also have a revenue tool that grows with the economy, like a portion of an income tax or like a sales tax. We don't have that available to us in the City of Toronto. So we fund transit from the fare box and from our property tax base, and it's not sustainable. We do need a new deal. Well, if we have a new revenue stream that will help us to ensure that we continue to operate our TTC at full capacity, it will also help us with the state of good repair that needs to be done on the TTC. When I started in 2019 and I was on the TTC board, at our first meeting, we released a report about the cost of state of good repair for the TTC. And in 2019, it was identified that just to keep our existing transit system going, that's the subways, the buses that we already had, would be $33 billion over 10 years. And we came up with a plan and we were making great strides on that. The new situation that we're in, resulting from the COVID-19 pandemic, with decreased ridership, with increased costs that we're seeing, not just through operating of our shelters, but also through inflation, that has really made the state of good repair work take a step back. And I'm very sad by that and disappointed. We need to get back there. We need to get back on track with our state of good repair on the TTC. That will continue to want riders to come when they have a very reliable, dependable system. And so we do need to advocate to those other levels of government. So what we've been told right now with the TTC is that they are continuing to prioritize deployment of service to ensure that where we need ridership, where we have ridership the most, that we continue to serve so we're not having crowding, making sure that we're servicing our priority neighborhoods. And there is a full commitment to continue to grow as ridership comes back. There has been some minor decreases in service. We want to get it back as soon as possible. We need people to ride. We need people to come back. But more importantly than that, what I'm saying here today is we need help from the provincial and the federal governments to help us with long-term operating costs of the TTC and to help the city as well. So the books are closing for 2022. So that is very much the problem I have at hand. That is my biggest concern right now. So it's that 235 from last year. The conversation about 2023 is continuing. The provincial government has been very good in engaging with us on those discussions, and I'm hopeful that we can start those conversations with the federal government. And I look forward to the new mayor on June 26th continuing that and getting a good deal for Toronto. So I think you're highlighting an important problem that we have, and that's where we're going back year over year for the same things. So a good example of that is our refugee shelters. We only recently found out that the federal government would reimburse us for our refugee shelter costs for 2022. We have not heard that commitment for 2023. So every single year we have to go back. We want to accept people in Toronto. We want this to be their home. We need the federal government to step up with a long-term commitment around that. There's many other things. Supportive housing is another good example where year after year, we go to the provincial government and we ask for funding. They've come through with the 2023 funding, but you're exactly right that longer-term deals around these things are very much needed. And it's helpful. It's helpful for us on the books. It gives us stability. It gives us the ability to expand in a sustainable way. So there is a lot of merit in looking into that too. I think that it's a formality. I think that you will see council vote to declare the seat vacant today and launch the by-election. I think that council, as much as they might may like or dislike me, I think they're eager to meet their new mayor. So I think we'll get that through council today. We have answered this question. The office of the mayor is independent and will continue to be independent. I am a voter. I will be voting on June 26th. So I'll be watching closely also. I think that all of council should look at that, see what their heart says, vote accordingly. But I also know that motions were passed around this last December. That was sent to Queen's Park and they haven't made any changes. So we can vote on how we feel about strong mayor powers, but ultimately it's up to the Ford government to decide what their stance is on strong mayor powers and if those should continue. I think that given we have strong mayor powers, the residents of Toronto should be watching very closely, paying even more attention than they have in the past, but I have every confidence in the people of Toronto to elect the right person on June 26th. Okay, thank you.